In the Communication Sciences and Disorders program here at James Madison University, we have a vision, and our vision was developed by our faculty. And our consensus was that we want to bridge science and clinical practice. What this means is that we want our students to understand the science that underlies what they're hoping to practice in, and that this will drive them to be able to make good decisions, to be problem solvers as they face a child in the school environment, as they face a stroke patient that's in a rehab facility. So we want them to be able to be good thinkers.
Audiology is a field that focuses on hearing healthcare. It is a clinical profession, and our program is a four-year doctoral program.
The first 3 years are where we get the bulk of our coursework, learning about different things, hearing aids, cochlear implants, oral rehabilitation, general anatomy, physiology. The fourth year is where we go off and we actually get clinical hours in the external placement. So that could be at a medical center, sometimes ENT practices. But during the first 3 years, we are also participating in clinical experience, such as our clinic downstairs on the first floor.
They are engaged in assessment, and then they may also have the opportunity to engage in hearing aid consults or hearing aid fittings. They are assigned a client or multiple patients within a week. And so they would follow through with those patients throughout the semester. Our clinic is really extraordinary in that we have audiology on one side and we have speech language pathology on the other. And then adjacent to the SLP side, we have the offices for the clinical educators. So they're right outside the door.
The benefit is that we teach the students in this building and they go and work with patients in the same building, and so there's a two-way communication between classroom and clinic. And in addition to that, we actually have a whole floor on the top floor dedicated to research. Any area that you can think of in audiology and hearing healthcare, we do cutting-edge research here. Now when you combine the classroom teaching, the clinical care, and the high-end research we do, our students are able to see all three facets of audiology at work. So we are very excited about this.
Our students are leaving with wonderful skill sets, and they're ready to go out there and be certified and licensed practitioners in a field that is very rapidly expanding.
There are so many different things that can be done with audiology, and with it being such a new field, that in the years in which we go on to practice, there's going to continue to be a progression and change in the demands of the field. So preparing us for that by teaching us as much stuff as they possibly can. And I think that's one of the greater characteristics about the university.
One thing that people sometimes don't realize is that we are the only audiology program in the Commonwealth of Virginia.
Something that we are very proud of this program is our people. Not only the faculty, we have top-notch, world-class faculty here. We also have top-notch students. I have a simple philosophy. When we train our programs, we are not training them as our students. We train them as our future colleagues. And when you take that philosophy, we say we're going to train you very with strong background in science so that when you graduate, you're able to adapt to several different areas.
We are charged with preparing students to go out to use evidence-based practices, which will be grounded in science, grounded in the research, to then care for people out in our communities. I want to know that we're sending out people that I would feel very comfortable with them caring for my mother, a young child. We want to make sure that we have quality students that we're putting out there. And we do.